Hello, music lovers. I am Bill Weir from CNN, and it's such a treat to welcome you here to our exclusive CNN Keep Watching conversation presented in partnership with the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as we get ready for CNN's new film called Carole King and James Taylor, Just Call Out My Name. This unlikely, brilliant collaboration, a girl from Brooklyn who was practicing perfect pitch at age four, this cello player from Waspy, New England. Together they come together and forge some of the best musical memories, certainly of my lifetime. And of course that led up to this triumphant concert series they did in 2010, recorded for this film as they also look back on their lives and making music together. And I'm thrilled to join in conversation with us, Rock and Roll Hall of Fame President and CEO, Greg Harris. Greg, good to see you. Happy holidays.
Hey, happy holidays to you. I'm sitting in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame right now in Cleveland, Ohio. And you see gear behind me. This is a space where visitors play instruments and jam with each other. And, you know, I'm sure these guitars have been picked up and people have played Carole King and James Taylor songs in this very room. And just to further set the stage, this museum is that beautiful pyramid on the shores of Lake Erie. On the third floor, right above me, is our Hall of Fame floor. And forever, James Taylor and Carole King, their names will be etched on our wall as the select few. There's only about 350 Hall of Fame inductees, and we're talking about two of them today. As you stated, their music impacted all of us. It really is the soundtrack that many of us grew up with. We had our hearts broken to, we had our hearts mended to, and it helped us all, I think, become better people.
Absolutely. I want to get into the particulars of their talents and what they brought to the annals of rock and roll. A huge fan of your museum. I would love to be in that room with you, trying to pick out the chords to Fire and Rain. But let's do the better thing. Let's show you a little sample of the film so you get a sense of what we're in for coming up on CNN. Here it is, Carole King, James Taylor, Just Call Out My Name.
Friends, collaborators, legends. Their music shaped a generation. They came together for the tour of a lifetime.
And it's too late, baby, now it's too late.
James Taylor.
His songs were amazing, his voice is amazing, and his demeanor.
Yeehaw.
And Carole King.
Carole King, one of the greatest songwriters of all time,
asked to be a part of my band.
I've seen fire and I've seen...
40 years have passed since the first time we played.
I love every experience we have had together.
You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running.
Just Call Out My Name. Sunday at 9 on CNN.
Greg, I know you had a chance to screen this. I watched it last night, and it was such a joyous 90-minute respite from another pandemic holiday season. In fact, James Taylor is supposed to go back on tour with Jackson Browne, a tour that's been postponed twice due to COVID. Fingers crossed he can get back out there, but this may be the next best thing in terms of seeing him live. But let's talk ladies first. Let's start with Carole King and her incredible career coming up through Tin Pan Alley, the Boys Club at the Brill Building, to write for everybody from Herman's Hermits to Aretha, a Natural Woman, and in addition to Tapestry, truly one of the greats of all time. What do you think resonates and what makes her a two-time Hall of Fame inductee?
Well, flat out, she's brilliant, right? Brilliant, and I guess to quote the Broadway show, beautiful. She's truly amazing. It's rarefied air to be inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame multiple times. In fact, there's only three female artists in history that are inducted twice. And Stevie Nicks was the first for her solo work and for Fleetwood Mac. And this year, we inducted Tina Turner as a solo artist for her great solo career post Ike Turner. And Carole King was inducted with her past husband and songwriting collaborator, Jerry Goffin, as a songwriter for all that amazing Brill Building work, for that stuff that you've quoted, Aretha songs, Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow, like just amazing, amazing stuff that she's writing as a teenager. as a teenager and through the early 60s. And then, you know, Carole steps out from behind the scenes, so to speak, as a writer, and she gets on stage. And that is where we have, you know, Carole King, her own records, and where Tapestry just is this groundbreaking record that everybody owned. Everybody knew what song was coming next because they played it so much. And and we all listened intently, and it just spoke to our soul. So that's the power and magic when a song can reach you, when she shares emotion that becomes universal, that becomes collective. And it helps us, I believe, grow as people. It helps us grow our empathy and our understanding. And she does it so well. And then this film, there's a story there. Like, the editors do an amazing job. You know, I was privileged to view it last night, where they're going through James and Carole on stage together in different decades, performing together. And you see this kind of this performance love affair that they have, mutual admiration, respect, and collaboration over decades. And all of us have aged over decades. So we kind of are with them. And it's so powerful. I was tempted, you know, we get these links as private links. I'm like, man, I can't wait to share this with. And I knew, you know, 20 people I wanted to tell to watch this. That's how good it is. Yeah, so just terrific. Thank you.
Well, it's interesting that I want to play here her acceptance speech, you know, getting inducted the second time. You see how amazing she still looks and has this just this bubbly energy. Even her sad ballads, there's a little, you know, little twirls of light in there that I think, as you talk about, touches us and helps us be more empathetic. But it was James Taylor who pushed her out on stage alone. She was happy being, as she says, a side man for him. But here, let's hear Carole King as she's honored at the Rock Hall.
I want to hold on to that, but it's heavy, as is tonight, but it's heavy and also light. I want to thank Taylor. Thank you for that awesome performance. And all of y'all, thank you. Thank you. That was amazing. And also, thank you for carrying the torch forward. You're like my professional granddaughter. I want to thank all of tonight's inductees for carrying the torch from rhythm and blues to rock and roll to the music that inspires us today. I have to start with Jerry Goffin. I owe so much to Jerry Goffin, whose lyrics nailed our deepest feelings. And Ms. Toni Stern, who wrote, "It's too late, baby, now it's too late." To Lou Adler, who recorded Tapestry as if I were playing a new song for a friend, and he gave me the confidence in 1971 to open for James Taylor at the Troubadour. Oh, thank you. Thank you. I love you too, and I want to say, you know, I'm kind of a hermit. And to come out tonight and see all old friends and new, and just all of you here tonight, to welcome all the inductees, and me as one of them, it's unbelievable. Thank you, thank you. You know, at this point, I am used to performing, and when, you know, that fateful night when the audience began to sing along and I felt them with me. And here we are, 51 years later. Wow. Thank you, James. To my mother, my first piano teacher, who exposed me to all kinds of music, to my father, who told me I could do anything. To my daughter and manager, Sherry Goffin Condor, who helps me do everything. And to Louise Goffin, who added to her parents' songwriting skills and continues to bring her own wonderful gift to the world. And to all my descendants, I love you so much. Now, I am told that today's female singers and songwriters stand on my shoulders. Let it not be forgotten that they also stand on the shoulders of the first woman to be inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. May she rest in power, Miss Aretha Franklin. We feel you, baby.
Such a generous soul. Yeah, isn't it amazing? And she let James Taylor record You've Got a Friend for Sweet Baby James while she was putting it on tap. I mean, who would do that today, who would give away one of their best songs? But that pivots us to James Taylor, Greg. And if you're trying to get your kids or your grandkids interested in this film, you can mention that Taylor Swift, who inducted Carole King, is named after James Taylor. And her induction speech is amazing. I'm sure you can see it on the Rock Hall there. But James Taylor, who had much more pain in his early life than I ever knew, to come up with his sound. What are your thoughts on James?
Yeah, you know, I love that circle, right, with Taylor Swift inducting Carole King. By the way, that was just a few weeks ago, that induction on our stages right here in Cleveland. And it's truly amazing. And it was lots of love from Taylor to Carol, and then Carol to Taylor and Aretha, and then to the fans. And that leads us to James Taylor, right? Because, you know, he is a sensitive singer-songwriter that came at a time when there was a lot of, you know, power and noise to rock and roll. A lot of different variants of rock and roll are there. And he comes with sort of that honest sound. But then it is amazing lyrics that do speak to you immediately, and the confidence, I guess, to bare his soul publicly on vinyl, on, you know, one of the first artists, I think, you noted earlier when we were aside, first U.S. artist signed to Apple Records, the Beatles record label. That's quite an endorsement. It's also, I think, daunting. And to step in and deliver, and then to have that strength. And we all, when you think of James Taylor's songs, I think we think and we feel, remember when we heard them? It's almost like a very gentle autumn breeze that's mm-hmm. whispering and speaking to you, and the way that it captures you. And then to hear that connection. So, you know, you need to take Carole King out of the Brill Building, out of the East Coast, writing for the Shirelles and Aretha and others. And we need to bring her out to California, to Laurel Canyon. And there's a whole scene happening there with the Mamas and the Papas and Joni Mitchell and Graham Nash. And then you've got James Taylor, who is writing amazing songs. This connection happens, this mutual respect. And next thing you know, she's getting on stage at the Troubadour with a connection to James Taylor. And he's recording her songs, and then it just weaves its way through. Just amazing. And the fact that he could writes with such honesty, performs with such grace, that it just speaks to us. And it doesn't always have to be loud. It can be just a well-crafted song delivered honestly and clearly with his unmistakable voice.
Amen, brother. And it's just so pure and honest, as you say. That's the key, that there's nothing fake about either one of these performers. Yeah. James, early in his life, committed himself for psychiatric care, struggled with depression early on, had to kick heroin a couple of times, broke both of his hands and feet just after closing the Newport Folk Festival in 69. It's a miracle he came back to play again. But thank goodness he did. And thank goodness these two stars collided in such a way to soothe our souls. It was great talking to you, Greg. I really appreciate your time, and I can't wait to get back to the Rock Hall in Cleveland. It's one of my favorite places in the country.
Well, we're open just about every day of the year, and we'd love to have you back. And it's interesting that I think at this moment when many of us are a bit isolated, that so many good music speaks to us even more. And then to see a production like this, where we're seeing the music through the decades, the fact that the footage was captured, the fact that it's been woven together in this format, and just how strong it is. This is, I can't wait to share it with friends. I can't wait to watch it again myself. And we're grateful for CNN putting these type of shows out there. Thank you. And it helps keep us all connected and bring us all together. Rock and roll is the most powerful art form ever created. And it truly is the music that connects all of us. So thank you.
Hey, man, we're just huge rock fans. We did Linda Ronstadt last holiday. A couple years before, we did the great Glenn Campbell documentary. So we're happy to come up with something around the holidays that brings multi-generations together and brings us all together at a time when we need it more than ever. Thanks again, Greg, for hanging. And we hope you enjoyed watching today's Keep Watching conversation presented in partnership with the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And a reminder, Carole King and James Taylor, Just Call Out My Name, will premiere on CNN January 2nd at 9 o'clock Eastern Time.